My bad. I was wrong aspect. I had to restart it. What's up? What are you doing, Rocky? Wait, let's see. I haven't done this in a while, I'm rusty. Okay. I'm just gonna start doing this because it's gonna take a while. Yeah. I'm gonna show you my spiral wrap cord. See the spirals? See how they spiral around. Pretty cool, yeah. Pretty cool, yeah. Okay. Rocky with the lotus. Okay, so I started doing this. This was the first one. Well, one of the first ones I did. It's a little thicker. And what I used for this was Baker's Twine, is what it's called. You can find it in the craft aisle of different places. I got this from the Dollar Tree, yeah. So this was a thinner one that I did, and it came out a lot better. I'm kind of getting better at it. You can see this was before. This is after, yeah. And this is my latest one. It looks a lot thinner. But I think the thinness happens with a combination of how many strings you use or threads. And how tight you pull it, how tight you wrap it. So these are the threads I'm gonna use. Look how thin they are. They're like super thin, yeah? So, what you're gonna do is you're gonna cut, and the ones that I find that's working really well, that's versatile with like all beads, pretty much, I think. I haven't really tested it on 275. You want one, Roger? Do you like the green? Isn't the green awesome? I don't know if you can see the green there. You can kind of not see it so well because of the light, the bright light. Yeah, I can make you one. Okay, so, but I'm going to show you how you can make your own. Okay, so this, what you're going to do is you're going to cut three strands, same length, yeah? Fold them in half. That's the first step. You fold it in half. So you have this little loop, yeah? Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a knot at the end. This is gonna hold all the threads together, and it's gonna be one of the ends. So it should hold itself. As a stopper, you know what I mean? Like a knot at the end of the bead. So, I like for the loop to be like as small as possible. Like, I don't want it to be too big because I like to hide the loop. Now, I'm going to show you how you have to like hook it so that you can work with it. Now, you can't see this very well. So, you're gonna get closer to me, yeah? You're gonna get closer. A little bit closer. So I wanna show you what to do. Okay, I got a carabiner, and that's gonna hold it, so you're gonna open it. You can't see that part. I'm gonna put it in, slide it down, and that's what's holding everything, yeah? So now I've got a total of 6 strands that are hanging. I'm just gonna pick one to start off with. And this one is gonna be away from the others. Now what I'm gonna do, is I'm going to cross it, hold them all. This is tricky to show. Wait. Hold all your strings with this hand. This hand right here is going to hold. So I'm doing a crisscross thing. You see what I'm doing? I'm only doing that because I'm gonna hold it with my thumb. I'm gonna go through all the strands, pull through like this, and then I'm gonna slide it all the way up. See what I did? I'm gonna do it again. Slide it all the way up. I found a tutorial how to do this, so don't think that I made this up because I didn't. But you can find a tutorial. And how tight you pull when you're doing the wrap determines your, the thickness of the cord. And you just keep doing that. Now what's happening is the spiral is just creating itself as you're pulling it. It's starting to create a little spiral pattern on its own. See, I'm not doing that. That's what happens. When it starts to get to the end of this of your cord, where it's coming to this side of you, you flip it underneath. And when you do that, that's when you do you start doing it again, the same wrap. That keeps your spiral going. So you gotta keep an eye out for that part of it at least. Hey Joe. What you doing, man? What you doing? Okay, let me see. Wait. Hold on. Oh! This is like a really short... This is gonna be a short one. I might use this for like a short game. I've been experimenting with length of string, like to find out how much I need. It's better to have more than less because you can always work with more. When you have less room to do your... See how small this one got compared to the others? So that's gonna make a difference. I like to start off with like 3 arms length long. So yeah, once you get a certain amount of color, you can switch color. And that's what I've been doing. I'm putting like tri-colors. The first one I did had like 4 colors, I think. Or did it have 3? No, it had 3, but it had more strings. You can see how it's like starting to create itself. And they say the braiding the cords, you know, it takes time, it takes a while to do. This is probably the quickest one I've found. I tried to do one of the traditional braided cords where you use like a disc. And that took forever, dude. Props to you people that do that. Chris and Deb and Erica, because you all have patience to do that. That takes a lot longer. This is relatively shorter time to do. Probably, I want to say 10-15 minutes maybe. Like a doesn't take that long. You got to make sure that while you're doing this, you keep these as pulled as much as you can, because you don't want them bunching up inside the middle. You want to keep it uniform as much as you can. Yeah. Like I said, you can do this your own self. This is like really easy to do. Believe me, if it would be more tricky, I doubt I would have tried to get into it or do it. But when I saw this tutorial, I was like, okay, this seems easy. This is like one of the easiest ones I've seen for braiding threads together and making your own little cords, doing your custom cords. So nobody's doing this, and I was like, you know me, I always gotta do stuff that nobody else is doing. Okay, that looks like getting too short now. So I'm gonna go for a green. I'm gonna go for green now. Every once in a while, I kind of like hold it so I make sure that it's all together and I don't have like too many strings showing through the wrap, because sometimes that happens. You can't tell, but like right here, that happened. So you kind of like push it up a little bit. I'm still figuring this out as I'm doing it. It's all trial and error. So yeah, if you just tuned in and you didn't see the beginning of this, I'll show you again like how to do that wrap. So you have all your strings on one side, and you have your single string on the other. You're gonna hold these strings. I'm right-handed, that's why I hold everything with my left. And then the one that you're gonna start threading through, you're gonna do like an L shape. Then you're gonna go through the hole and grab it and then pull it like that all the way up. And that's all I'm doing. It's an L shape around all the other strings. Right now it's like about that long. See how long it is now? I'm telling you, dude, this is quick. This doesn't take a long time. These are short strands, though, and I've been used to using longer ones, so that's what's kind of slowing me down. Once you switch colors, it looks pretty tight, man. But I haven't done a full one color cord yet. I probably will. So I want to see how that looks. And I'll save one for you, Rocky. Thank you. lot of frames, not even like looking at the frames, so I don't know. Now, as you all know, if you know, I'm mostly long game, yeah? So I like to make mine long. I've only been making them long so far. This is the first one that's going to be short. Shorter than I'm used to, but I just wanted to do one to show how it's done. So this is like the spare strings that I had left over. Now, if you can see those spirals? Check that out. Look how it does. Look how pretty. And this is one of those things that you won't get lost. If I put it down and the phone rings, I go walk away. I can always come back because I can tell where I left off. All these strings are together, and this one's by itself. So it's easy to pick up where you left off, see, like if I drop it. It's not the end of the world. Dude, how short is this one? Okay, I still have room. It's gone this long now. See, that's how long it is. I still have room for, let me see, I want to compare how long it is to what I already have. It's about halfway to this one, which is my short game. But before I stop, I like it to be a little bit longer. I'm gonna use red now. Be done with this. I have some time, then I'll freestyle. But I want to show you how I stop it. How I come to an end. Was I out of frame all this time? Y'all gotta tell me something, man. I'm not looking. Tell you, when there's shorter strands, it's kind of harder to work with. I like to have super long strands so I can just pull them. Not have to worry about losing any. When you're short like this, it's a little tricky. I almost got it. Almost. I'm getting there. Oh, the pressure. Can you feel the suspense? The suspense is killing me. Okay, that's the last one I'm gonna do. Now I'm gonna take this off. I'll show you how this ended up. Check that out. Look at that bad boy right there. So I got brown, I got red, I got green, brown, red. If I would have had more, I could have made another strand of like green or something. But that's neither here nor there, my friend. At this point.
How much time do you have?
Oh,
so much time.
Okay. So, I will show you how to keep this all together so that you're ready to, like, thread it. Get me mad. You don't like me when I'm mad. You don't like me when I'm angry. I cry when I get angry. Okay, I don't know why, but I said next on copycat. I don't know why I said that. So now that puts me in a hole. So I'm going to show you like what my progress is so far on that. I don't know if you can even... My progress so far has been... Oh, I'll show you how I do copycats. Like how I have no idea how to do most of those tricks in those orders. When I see it, I just say next, and then I learn on the fly. So I saw this one starts like this. I practice that first one first, the first move. Practice the first move until I can get the first move to where it ends for the second, like right there, that ends for the second. Get closer, you can't see. This is the first move, then it stops here for the current copycat, then there's a weave that goes on, but I don't understand why weaves are just half weaves. I think of a weave like this, like completing the figure eight, completing the figure eight, and no one ever does that in a copycat. I notice they just do half a weave and then they do other stuff, so I guess that's what it's called. I don't really know. Who am I to judge? I don't even know any of the trick names. To this day, I still don't really know them. I kind of do, then I forget. So, okay. So that's how far I have so far. I get this down. Wait. It's just a learning process. You know, I'm doing the wrong gap. When I get to this point, I need to learn the next trick. So I'll practice the trick right before it, and now it's the weave, and it goes into a index mid transfer. That's how I do that one. So I have to practice doing that till I have it down. And there's a lot of dropping that happens when I'm learning how to do these. So that's how I'm going to do that. From here, I have to practice rebound into thumb. So it's rebound. Wait, I messed up. It's rebound into thumb. So I'll practice that for a while. Once I know I can do that one easy, then it goes into index roll. I can do that pretty easy. Index roll. Now this is the part right here that's gonna freak me out. So I'll do index roll and then I try to do the next one. And then Sam just had to do this. He just had to do a skip roll. I'm still struggling doing that. There it is. So I try to do that first until I have that down. Then I work my way backwards, like one step back. Let's see. Now, so close. Okay, there it is. There it is. Wait. There it is. I already know what I'm gonna do for the end. It's just a part, it's just the whole challenge for me now is doing all the parts together as a copycat before I can do my crazy. You want to see what I'm going to do? You can't see because it's too bright. There. I'm trying to do something like that.
Oh!
Don't tell anybody, okay? Let's keep it a secret. Let's keep it to ourselves, shall we? Okay, yeah. I will try. How much time do I have? Oh, I have a little bit of time left. Okay. Let's see if I can try this again. Yeah. linking all those parts together is the tricky part. Because I can never do a copycat straight from it. I have to learn it in pieces. But putting it all together is... Now that's the trick for me. In my short term, I forget everything I just learned. So close, I almost had it. Natural for me to do a thumb middle finger transfer. It's harder for me to think of doing an index middle finger transfer. That's not natural for me. I just always do a thumb one. So that's where you have to get out of your comfort zone, Claudia. Oh, there it goes again. Oh. Yep. God damn. You just had to do that, didn't you? There it is. Okay. So now I'm going back to retraining myself how to do this one. Because I forgot it. So tricky, because you gotta go over the two fingers first and then move that finger out of the way so then it does only that finger. Yeah. It's easy to do it just by itself, but when you do it from another roll, that's the hard part right there. See, I want to just go straight to, I can do this one, I can go straight to the middle, but that's not what it is. I know if I do that, Sam, the man, is going to throw down the gavel and tell me, no, that's not how you do the transfer. Oh no, it's not a transfer, my bad. It's, what is it? Oh, a skip roll, yeah. No, that is not how you do the skip roll. I don't know how you talk, Sam, but I know you're French, and I don't have a good French accent. But I'm gonna try anyway. So Sam's gonna be like, no, that is not how you do the skip roll. Give me laughy faces if you like how I do my Sam impersonation. No, the skip roll is not like that. No. Foul, I call foul on you. I will tell judges. They will say, no, no, that is not how you do it, wee wee. Hello, how are you, Xenios? Is it Xenios or Xenios? So I know a guy named Xavier, and some people call him Javier, but that's because he's Hispanic. So, like, maybe you say, Genios, right? Is it Genios? Is the X silent? But everybody says his name, Javier, they say it with the X because it has an X. So they say Xavier. So I don't know. Tell me if I'm doing it right. Tell me if I'm saying it right. Okay. I'm getting distracted here. I'm trying to be a copycat. You distracted me, Genios. Oh no! And maybe I should do like an aerial at the end, right? I have a feeling no one's gonna follow me. Oh, is that it? That's it. That's it, and that's my time. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later. Keep on streaming. Do things you never do. Try new things. And you'll have fun with what you learn, yeah?